To date, we've administered over 3.3 million doses to eligible DoD personnel, with 58% of our active duty service members having had at least one dose. Note that 1 month ago, when we opened vaccination to all, we were only at 37% of active duty service members receiving one dose. So we're making good, steady progress. DoD has had nearly 300,000 cases, just over 4,000 hospitalizations, and unfortunately, 351 deaths. These are total numbers that include our military service members, their dependents, civilians, and contractors. It's also important to note that COVID-19 infection incidents and testing positivity rates for DoD personnel are lower than for the civilian population, which is a sign that our force health protection measures are working. We are a reflection of society, so I would imagine that those that may be, and we don't know the answer to this, like refusing vaccination, may reflect what we're seeing out in the civilian sector. That said, there's no plans at this time to make vaccine mandatory. If and when the FDA does license the vaccine, we'll make a decision at that time.
I don't think we've reached a point where our efforts need to stop. Our efforts stop when we've eliminated people dying from this disease. Our efforts stop when we've eliminated people being admitted to the hospital for this. And our efforts stop when it stops being a negative aspect to the way that commanders do commander business.